Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the characteristic equation, poles and zeros of a transfer function. First we will start with the poles and zeros of a transfer function. Let us first write the formula for the transfer function. Transfer function GS, it is defined as the Laplace transform of the output and the Laplace transform of the input. So it is Ys by Xs. If we write it in the differential equation form, then it will be the Laplace transform of output, it is given by so this is the representation of a transfer function. Now, the numerator polynomial of the transfer function, it is having m roots, and the denominator polynomial, it is having n roots. So, if we represent this transfer function in the form of the factorized form, that is in the form of its roots, then it will be so the factors of the numerator polynomial, there are m factors. So each factor, it is represented by z0, z1, z2 till zm. So there are m roots of the numerator polynomial and there are n roots of the denominator polynomial, p0, p1, p2 till pn. So the roots of the numerator polynomial, they are known as the zeros of the transfer function. So zeros will be z0, z1, z2 till zn, okay? Or if we represented it in a general form, then it is zi are the zeros of the transfer function, where I ranges from 0, 1, 2 till m, okay? And the roots of the denominator polynomial, that is the p0, p1, p2 and pn, these are all called the poles of the transfer function. So p0, p1, Pn, these are all the poles. So if we write it in general form, then Pj are the poles of the transfer function, where j ranges from 0, 1, 2 till n. Okay, so there are m zeros and n poles of the transfer function. So these are the poles and zeros. Now let us study that what is a characteristic equation of a transfer function. So let us find what is the characteristic equation of a transfer function. Let us first write how we define the transfer function. Gs is equals to Ys by Xs, and it is given by B naught Sm . So this is the transfer function, and if we take the denominator polynomial of a transfer function, then it is given in terms of s. So if we equate this denominator polynomial to 0, then we will obtain an equation. Let's equate this denominator polynomial to 0. So this equation which we have obtained . It is called the characteristic equation of a transfer function. So in this way, you can find out the characteristic equation of a transfer function. So in this video, we have studied about the poles and zeros and characteristic equation of a transfer function. I hope you have understood it well. Thank you.